Well, good afternoon, and I am really delighted to welcome everybody to what I know is going to be a very exciting afternoon. I'm Linda Fried, and I have the honor of serving as the Dean of Columbia University's Mailman School of Public Health, and today I have a particular honor of introducing the introducer of our final Grand Rounds for the year in what has been an immensely exciting series. Our Grand Rounds on the Future of Public Health occurs monthly. Its goal is to bring us together as an intellectual and scholarly community in the Mailman School of Public Health and across the Columbia University Medical Center to consider the challenges for public health for the future, our responsibilities in solving them, and in particular this year, in a series entitled The Public Health Imagination, to understand how people in every sector are engaging on public health issues, collaborating across sectors to solve them between academia, industry, the corporate industry, and government, and bringing solutions out into all parts of the world. And today's conversation and discussion and talk is going to particularly be salient to the issues of our future. To introduce both the topic and our speaker, I'm extremely pleased to introduce Professor Joe Graziano, a professor of environmental health sciences, the director of our Environmental Health Superfund project, which is a global project, and the yet again interim chair of the Department of Environmental Health. Joe.
Thank you, Dean Fried, and I want to welcome everyone to this special event for the Environmental Health Sciences Department. It's the 23rd annual Granville Sewell lecture, and it's one that we take great pride in each year, choosing a visitor who we think is really very special and lives up to the our memories and the reputation of Granville Sewell. Granville Sewell was a faculty member in environmental health sciences. He joined the faculty in 1967. His training was really in engineering. He had his bachelor's degrees and PhD in really environmental engineering. And it's somewhat appropriate after 23 years. Today is the first time we've had a Sewell lecturer who's an engineer and has accomplished a great deal, as you will see. Granville sadly died prematurely in 1992, and this lectureship was developed to honor his memory. And I should tell you that Granville is remembered by his mentorship of generations of students, and I see some of them in the room. His office was always open to students. His home was always open to students. He brought in students to stay with him from abroad. He did a great deal of international work on the engineering front, as our speaker today has. And so it's our continued honor to have this event in Granville's memory. To introduce our speaker today, Dr. Ian von Lindern received degrees in chemical engineering, biometeorology, and atmospheric studies, and then finally a degree in environmental science and engineering at Yale. Ian is the executive director of Terragraphics International Foundation. Now, Terragraphics was an environmental engineering firm that he founded in 1984, and it grew to be quite a large enterprise with 140 employees, and it's situated in Idaho, and you'll see as he talks about the Bunker Hill, the infamous Bunker Hill smelter site in Idaho. Was instrumental in cleaning up this incredible former smelter site. 10 years ago, Ian sold the company and developed the foundation that is now a nonprofit, the Terragraphics International Foundation. And in the past 10 years, he and his wife, Margaret, who's Margaret von Braun, who's here and is the former dean of graduate studies at the University of Idaho, together, this husband and wife team, has taken on annually a significant project requiring environmental engineering expertise and using the model that Ian developed in Bunker Hill, Idaho, to clean up an enormous contaminated site and bringing that expertise abroad. I met Ian in 2004 when I was a member of an NRC committee. NRC is the National Research Council, which is the implementation arm of the National Academy of Sciences. And the committee was commissioned to go to the Bunker Hill site, to Idaho. And EPA had made some decisions that were being challenged. And I won't take your talk away from you. They were being challenged, and the committee was sent in to do a couple of things. First, the science that EPA was using to make its decisions was being challenged basically by politicians in Idaho who were concerned that it would have ramifications to their economy. And so I had a chance to meet Ian and learn about what he had accomplished in the previous decades. And in short, the committee came down with two conclusions. First, the science that EPA did was valid, it was sound. And the second was that the work that Ian had done with Terragraphics and others had effectively solved the lead poisoning problem in the Bunker Hill region. And so we recognize him today for his work not only in Bunker Hill, but his incredible work around the world. I said to the faculty in EHS when I nominated him, he's a public health hero. He's an engineer who is a real public health hero. And so, Ian, welcome.